JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for July the 13th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mostly lower on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained only against the Japanese yen, while it lost the most ground versus the Aussie, the Kiwi, and the Canadian dollar. The weakening of the US dollar and the safe haven yen, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie, Kiwi, and Loonie, suggests that markets may have traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the German DAX as well as Wall Street's S&P 500 and Nasdaq hitting fresh record highs. The optimism rolled over into the Asian session today as well, with Hong Kong's Hang Seng gaining the most. Now, although worries about the pace of the economic recovery remain elevated due to the vast spreading of the COVID Delta variant, evident by the slump in travel stocks, equities remain supported, perhaps due to investors increasing their risk exposure on defensive sectors. What's more, concerns over a slowing global recovery could be translated into expectations that some major central banks may have to delay tightening plans in case the spreading of the coronavirus worsens. Paradoxically, this may have been a supportive factor for some equities, as it means lower borrowing costs for companies for longer, as well as a higher discounted present values. Today, market participants are likely to lock their gaze on the US CPIs for June as they try to estimate when Fed officials are likely to push the rate hike button. The headline CPI rate is forecast to have ticked down to 4.9% year over year from 5%, while the core one is anticipated to have inched up to 4% from 3.8%. At its latest meeting, the FOMC kept its policy unchanged, but signaled that interest rates are likely to start rising in 2023. Since that meeting, we've heard the individual views of several policymakers, with some of them supporting that interest rates should even start rising during 2022, and others arguing against withdrawing monetary policy support too soon. The divided Fed was also reflected in the minutes of the gathering, with various participants feeling that the conditions for reducing their asset purchases would be met somewhat earlier than they had anticipated, while others saw a less clear signal from incoming data and suggested a patient approach to any policy change. Overall, though, they generally agreed that it is important to be well positioned to reduce the pace of asset purchases in case there is faster than anticipated progress towards the committee's goals. In our view, a rising core CPI rate could add more credence to the view that the surge in inflation may eventually not be due to transitory factors and could increase expectations that the Fed may indeed start normalizing its monetary policy sooner than previously thought. According to the Fed Fund Futures, market participants expect the first rate hike to be delivered in March 2023, but a rising core CPI rate may bring that timing forth and thereby support the US dollar. At the same time, equities are likely to correct lower, but we believe that the main focus for equity investors is likely to be second quarter earnings, with big banks reporting this week. Today, we will get results from JP Morgan Chase, Goldman Sachs, and Bank of America. Expectations are for a growth of 65.8% for companies in the S&P 500, up from a previous forecast of 54% at the start of the period. Solid earnings are likely to encourage more equity buying, and thus we don't expect a major pullback in stock indices in case data show that underlying inflation continue to accelerate in the US. We believe that expectations around the Fed's future course of action may be reflected more in the FX sphere. Even if so, the market's response may still be relatively cautious, as on Wednesday and Thursday, Fed Chief Jerome Powell will testify before Congress, and thus investors and traders may get clearer hints with regards to the Fed's plans directly from him. Now, tonight, during the Asian morning Wednesday, the spotlight is likely to fall on the RBNZ, which decides on monetary policy. Although no policy action is expected, the tone of the accompanying statement may play a major role in shaping expectations over the bank's policy plans. Last week, market participants brought forth their bets over when this bank will push the hike button, with 60% of New Zealand's financial sector firms expecting interest rates to rise over the coming year. This happened after a closely watched business confidence index jumped to its highest level in 4 years. With all that in mind, investors may dig into the statement for clues and hints as on how optimistic policymakers are and when they may be thinking to start raising rates. Although inflation remains below the midpoint of the bank's 1-3% target range, New Zealand has so far avoided a major outbreak of the COVID's Delta mutation, which may allow officials to be more optimistic than previously. This could support the kiwi at the time of the announcement, but bearing in mind that the FX traders' sentiment may also be affected by expectations surrounding a potential Fed tightening, we don't believe that an upbeat RBNZ could prove the catalyst for a major bullish trend reversal in kiwi dollar. It could just result in another small corrective bounce. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European session, we already got Germany's final CPIs for June, which just confirmed their preliminary estimates. Later in the day, after the US CPIs, the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories is coming out, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. As for the speakers, we do have one on today's agenda, and this is Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.